Hello, everyone. Welcome to Championship Wrestling. Vince McMahon here at ringside, standing next to one of wrestling's greats, Mr. Pat Patterson. Where this week, Pat will take a look at certainly a good friend of yours, the Intercontinental Champion, Pedro Morales.
Well, you know, Vince, Pedro's always mentioned that he likes to compete against the toughest men, and that's what he's been doing lately. And I tell you, nothing has stopped him yet, and Pedro is truly, in my book, a real champion.
No doubt of it. And scheduled as well, the $5,000 Cobra Clutch Challenge continues. And this week, Sergeant Slaughter will slap that Cobra Clutch on a man who definitely can get out of it, I believe, making reference to Quick Draw, Rick McGraw.
Well, you know, Vince, I was tempted to go in there myself, for $10,000 is a lot of money. Now, Rick McGraw is going in for $5,000.
Only for you.
Only for me, it's a lot of money. But for Rick McGraw, it's only $5,000, but $5,000 is a lot of money. And Vince, I have a feeling if someone can get out of that Cobra Clutch, will be Rick McGraw, and I'm looking forward to see that.
Also scheduled to join us, the tag team title holders, to open up things, as a matter of fact, in a non-title match. It'll be Tony Garea and Rick Martel.
You know, I saw Tony Garea and Rick Martel last week in California. And I'm still looking for these guys to get tired. Vince, I don't know how to do it. These guys are in fantastic shape. They keep going and they'll never stop. It's gonna be gonna have to be a tough team to beat these guys and take the championship away from them, because believe me, they are on top and they are in greatest shape that I've ever seen them.
Also scheduled to join us, as a matter of fact, the newcomer will have a word with Pat Patterson later on in the appearance of the magnificent Morocco. But in a moment, we'll return with our tag team match in a moment. Discretionary viewer participation is advised for the following wrestling exhibition.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Championship Wrestling, promoted by Phil Zatko, supervised by the State Athletic Commission, the Honorable J.J. Binns, Chairman, and the officials assigned, the Chief Deputy Commissioner in Charge, Billy Longo, Deputy Commissioner Peter Lash, the doctor in attendance at ringside, Dr. George Saharian, the timekeeper at the bell, Mike Mittman, and the referees for this hour of wrestling, Mario Savoldi, Gilberto Roman, Dick Worley, and my name is Jimmy Gill. On the opening contest, it is a non-title tag team match. It is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing from parts unknown, weighing 225 pounds, here is the Black Demon. And his partner from New York City, weighing 239 pounds, here is the unpredictable Johnny Ross. And their opponents are making their way down the aisle. Step into the ring in a moment. And ladies and gentlemen, the World Wrestling Federation's tag team champions from Quebec City, Canada, weighing 234 pounds, Rick Martel. And his partner from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 244 pounds, Tony Garea.
Just a non-title match, as we outlined earlier, to open up things. Garea and Martel never looked any better, but I suspect that they'll be rivaled here by the combination of Rods and the Demon. We're set for the action to commence. Thank you. Johnny Rods, Ricky Martel in a rope. Nice shoulder block by Rick Martel, recovering his balance. Arm drag, take down again. Right back working on the same arm.
Vince, I've kind of sound repetitious a lot, but they are, in my book, the greatest tag team combination I've seen in a long, long time. As I was saying earlier in the beginning of the program, I'm looking forward. I mean, I'm looking to see if these guys would get tired at one time or another, and that they never get tired, and all the traveling that they have to do and facing the tough team all over the country, all over the world, they keep themselves in fantastic condition.
Martel not doing all that well for himself at the moment as a result of the aggressive tactics of Johnny Rods. Martel face first down to the knee of the Demon. Martel to the rope again, headed off Rods with an elbow clearly on the butt of the jaw. Wide open now, a shot by the Demon as Rods held wide open. Rick McGraw, you hear the chant, let's go Rick. Nice forearm smash by Martel, another elbow. A Rick in a face turns it back to the way the Demon wants it. To the rope now, the buckle. Here comes the Demon, look out. And right away, Martel gets control and then tags his partner, Tony Garea. Very wise decision.
Vince, this is what makes him great. He didn't hesitate and waste his time to go and tag his partner.
Tony Garea now executing an arm drag, takedown, and a whoa, real ram there with a knee to the arm. Another capacity crowd here with us at the arena enjoying the pro wrestling action. We certainly hope you're enjoying it wherever you may be. Garea with a takedown. And the referee having a little difficulty now in maintaining order. Ooh, Martel with an elbow. Was there a tag there, Pat? I don't believe there was.
Well, actually, the referee didn't see the tag, Vince. But Garea didn't notice that the referee's back was turned. But I would have made the tag. He just got kicked in the stomach by
Johnny Rods again interrupting things a bit. Is the Demon now with a handful of hair, rams the head of Martel to the canvas. No block. Demon go. Rods enters the ring, jumping over the top rope. He is cat-like in many, many respects. Listen to the fans.
You know, one thing that Martel does when you come and face him, he just stares at you right in the eye.
Rod's one of the most underrated wrestlers in pro wrestling today. He can mix it up with any of them. Kick to the midsection. Rod's crafty. Oh, but talk about craft. Look at that. What finesse. Ooh, Rick in the face. Johnny Rods with Martel, whips him to the buckle. Shoulder block, Johnny Rods moving in now. Rods blocked and Martel on target. Martel whipping Johnny Rods about now, elbow crush. Rods reaching for the tag, Garea will tag Rods. The Demon in to help out. Tag was made as Garea works on the left arm. Johnny Rods can turn it around awfully quick. Ooh, crushing blow to the ropes.
Vince, you never know what to expect out of Johnny Rods. They don't call him unpredictable for nothing. 1 minute he may look hurt and you turn your back and you're in trouble.
Count it two. Rods close to pinning Tony Garea. Tag was made and so was Garea. Attack Martel. Look at Martel go. The Demon for the ride. Martel. Beautiful flying head scissor. Another one. Martel on fire this week. Rods to the ropes now. Off the rope. And Rods gets more of the same. Martel is really lifting him up and putting him down.
Boy, you haven't seen it in a long time in wrestling. Somebody throwing a beautiful flying head scissor, Vince.
Rods is out to lunch. Left hand by Martel. The tag is made. Tony Garea now will enter. Wide open, Johnny Rods. cover. Referee out of position. But I don't believe it had a count of three anyhow. Rods is a tough cookie to put down.
You know, many times Johnny Rods has hurt, but he always knows what's going on in that ring. He always knows what's happening in there. He may be in a lot of trouble a lot of times, but he knows exactly what's happening.
Although he certainly appeared confused there for a while, Pat, when he was going from Gurria to Martel in a circle in the no man's land over in the corner a moment ago.
Very true, Vince, but I'm sure he was listening for that count. One and two. When he heard two, he kicked right out.
Rods appears to be tiring a bit. Rods has been in for most of the match, but he misses with the knee. Tag made on a part of Rods and the Demon, likewise on a part of Gurria and Martel. Back kick misses by a mile. Don't think he'd want to slug it out with a fellow like Martel. He's so quick. Look at that left hand as well as the right. A scoop now. Down across the knee. Could very well do it. We have one, and that's all. The Demon now with Martel up. Beautifully executed suplex, a cover in position to it. No. That was a tough one to get out of on the part of Rick Martel.
It was, Vince. When you, usually when someone gives you a suplex, it'll knock the wind out of you, I'll tell you that.
Johnny Rods has been tagged, and he enters by way of the top rope. Double team effort now. The referee distracted a moment ago by Tony Gurria. Here comes Johnny Rods. Oh!
This is where Johnny Rods made a mistake. He telegraphed this too much, Vince.
Tony Gurria whipping Rods to the rope, setting him up. Back body drop. Rods out to lunch. Martel doesn't help. Neither does Gurria. To the rope again. No, to the corner. Still no tag. Now Rods turns around, finally tagging the Demon. Snap bear over to Demon now, ramming the knee to the chest area. Cover. Won't get him. Thanks to Johnny Rods, they won't get him.
You know, you must say, if you're in a tag team match and you have Johnny Rods as a partner, you must say that you have a good partner. He's always there to help you.
Rods trying to set him up. Look at Rods giving instructions now to the Demon. Rods wants him off the top rope. Right into the small of the back. Rod scooping up Gurria. More punishment to the back. Off the rope. No. Rod's recovering, tagging the Demon. Likewise, Gurria recovers. Uppercut by the Demon. Snap bear over goes Martel. Off the rope, the Demon. Down goes Martel again. Look, what a maneuver by Martel. Leapfrog. Oh, he cleared him by 3 feet. Drop kick. Nails him. Tag made. Gurria over the top rope. Drop kick by Gurria. Martel and Gurria with a series of drop kicks, and the Demon keeps coming right back at him. Off the rope. Leapfrog back around. Tony Gurria hooks him, has him up, spins him around. Airplane spin. Dumps him on his back. Covers. One, two. It's over.
They do so many taggings in and out, Vince, that they completely confuse their opponent. And that's exactly what he did here this week. They just tag in and out so quick. Their opponent is completely confused of what's happening or who's legally in the ring.
Teamwork personified.
And here is the time of the fall. 9 minutes and 42 seconds. The winners, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion, Rick Martel, Tony Gurria.
Martel and Gurria with a hard-fought victory this week. Rods can't understand what happened, having a little difficulty with the referee as well as his partner. We'll be back as we continue with the newcomer, the magnificent Morocco.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Panama City, weighing 220 pounds, it is Steve King. And his opponent is making his way down the aisle. He is being led down the aisle by his manager, the one and only Grand Wizard of Wrestling. And from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 245 pounds, making his first appearance in this arena, here is the magnificent Morocco.
The magnificent Morocco. He is one fine, well-conditioned athlete from the looks of things. We'll see what he can do against Steve King. Here we go. Morocco, oh my, lifting the knees right up in the butt of the jaw. Magnificent Morocco with Steve King toying around with him at the moment. Oh, I don't believe I've ever seen that before, Pat.
I have never did, Vince. That's one way to break somebody's neck, I'll tell you.
What do you know about the Magnificent Morocco?
Well, Vince, I've seen him quite a few times across the roads. And I'll tell you, he's a man also, that the type of wrestler that he can do just about anything in the ring. He's a very good wrestler. And when he chooses to break the rules, he can do it. But he can wrestle. I mean, he knows his amateur background, and he knows his wrestling. And he's truly an athlete.
Morocco from Hawaii.
Vince, look at the arms on him.
Massive. Listed, I believe, at 260-something, I believe the ring announcer said. He looks bigger, Pat.
He does look bigger, Vince. So he looks very good body-wise.
Well-proportioned, well-conditioned. The Grand Wizard, his latest find, the Magnificent Morocco.
You know, many times in wrestling, some guys will just know how to brawl or how to fight, but some of the guys just know wrestling. But
all right, now Steve King's trying to give him a run for his money. King gets nowhere, tries it again. Morocco goes down, up, nails him. What you were saying, Pat? I'm sorry.
Some guys that just know their wrestling, but Morocco can wrestle. He can really apply all sorts of wrestling moves and suplex and name it, he can do it.
We just saw a beautiful maneuver a moment ago. Morocco, oh! Right across the chest, I'm sure that's all she wrote. Listen to the boos. Morocco. Not greeted with much of an ovation here at all. His initial appearance, let's get the time.
Here is the time, 2 minutes and 57 seconds, and the winner, the Magnificent Morocco.
Boy, he is magnificent. Magnificent looking, that you have to hand him. Morocco, along with his manager, the Grand Wizard. Let's go now to some slow motion action as we pick it up in the latter stages. Here's Steve King. Really wasn't into the match well at all. And look at that maneuver, Pat.
Man, Steve King already has a sore neck from earlier, and now he must really be out. Here comes Morocco from the second row. He climbs up the second row.
The referee could have counted him out long before this happened.
I agree with you.
Steve King, no competition for the Magnificent Morocco. We shall return in a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, making his first appearance in this arena from New York City, weighing 245 pounds, here is Peter Mitchell. And his opponent in the corner to my right, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 240 pounds, here is SD, Special Delivery Jones.
Special D with quite an ovation, and Jones never looked any better. Jones against relative newcomer Pete Mitchell. Here we go. Mitchell trying it again. Jones with a very nice and very easy escape.
I was talking to Jones earlier, Vince, and he's really, really happy with himself and wrestling in main events in different parts of the country, and he's really, really satisfied. He came a long way.
Well, SD, somewhat of a native son to the World Wrestling Federation. This is where it all started for SD Jones. And as you brought out, he's doing very, very well for himself now, Pat.
I was telling him, I said, SD, that's only the beginning. That's only half of it. He says, I know, man. It's, I ain't backing out from nobody.
Jones, those massive upper arms, he really looks good. Nice takedown by SD Jones.
I had the pleasure to be in the gym with him one time, and I've never seen someone sweat so much as SD Jones. When he starts working out, he's like a machine, he never stops.
Now the SD Jones headlock will obviously be a heck of a lot more effective than the headlock we saw earlier by Pete Mitchell.
Without a doubt, Vince. Look at those arms.
Mitchell may have been gnawing on the ear of Jones a little bit, I'm not too sure. Mitchell doesn't really seem to know what he's doing with SD Jones.
Well, it seems to me like he doesn't know to do about wrestling, but so he figures if he can't wrestle, he's gonna go and bite or and gouge an eye or something.
Big at butt by Jones. Jones lets him have it again. Mitchell falling to the canvas. SD gets the Duke. I'm not too sure Mitchell's shoulder was down. But you got the impression SD could certainly polish off Mitchell anytime he wanted. Let's get the official time.
Here is the time, 2:52 on the winner, SD Jones.
Special Delivery Jones. Victorious, and some slow motion action will show us a couple of headbutts by SD Jones. He's really patented those headbutts, hasn't he, Pat?
He has, Vince. Here he goes. Vince, he's put everything he's got into that headbutt.
Mitchell
is
out.
He's not satisfied. He wants to give him another one.
That's right. And Mitchell, I think, was out on his feet in there. He rears back and just lets him have it. Jones covering him on the victory. Scheduled next, ladies and gentlemen, will be the $5,000 Cobra Clutch Challenge. And if anyone can collect that $5,000, it's gonna be quick draw. Rick McGraw, he gives it 100% no matter what he's doing. So we'll be back with Slaughter and McGraw as we continue in a moment.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next attraction is the $5,000 Cobra Clutch Challenge. And here, ladies and gentlemen, is the challenger. He's ready to step into the ring from Charlotte, North Carolina. Weighing 236 pounds, here is Rick McGraw.
All right.
And here, ladies and gentlemen, to defend his Cobra Clutch Challenge, here he is, he's coming into the ring, being led down the aisle by his manager, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling from South Carolina, weighing 305 pounds. Here is Sergeant Slaughter.
Listen to the fans. Gomer, Gomer, Gomer.
You know, Vince, Rick McGraw is showing him his muscle, and he's telling him, come on in, I'm ready. I have a feeling Rick McGraw's gonna do it, Vince.
Oh, there's no doubt. McGraw can't wait. Slaughter, holding his ears, does not like what he hears.
Vince, McGraw told me earlier, he said, Pat, you don't find $5,000 on a street corner. There's a chance for me to make $5,000. I'm confident I'm going over there, and I'm going to do it.
Listen, Gomer, Gomer, in the background, you see the word, that huge sign, one big banner that says Gomer. Pat, I'll tell you, yes, sir, McGraw is ready. He studied the hold, and he honestly feels that there is an escape, and he has it. There's that $5,000 check signed by Sergeant Slaughter, paid to the order of blank. You can almost fill it in, though.
You see, Vince, McGraw is sitting there, and he's psyching himself. And
I think
Slaughter,
he's trying to psych Sergeant Slaughter as well.
Yeah, and Slaughter is just aggravating him. You know, he's taking his time, and what a wondering about the crowd because they're hollering Gomer.
Look at that, Slaughter pointing to the Gomer sign now. He's absolutely berserk. Slaughter making Rick McGraw think about it an awful lot. Look at McGraw. Slaughter, and more specifically, the Grand Wizard, a master in the use of psychology. But you can see this crowd, this capacity crowd distracting, Sergeant Slaughter. Now.
Vince, I hope he does it. I really do.
Look at the heavy muscular structure on Rick McGraw. A lot of upper body strength. Heavy trapezius area, pectoral development. And again, the crowd starting to pick up the chant. Ah, McGraw didn't like something. Slaughter makes him think about it a little bit more.
Well, you know, Slaughter could lose $5,000 this weekend. I think he's not too sure of himself.
Well, there's no doubt this is the toughest test yet Sergeant Slaughter has faced with his $5,000 Cobra Clutch Challenge.
Vince, the whole wrestling world is talking about the Cobra Clutch. Every wrestler is talking about it. They want to go into the ring and challenge him. They're not sure. They're not ready. Everybody's talking about it.
McGraw is so frustrated at this point. Waiting, waiting, waiting for Sergeant Slaughter to clamp it on. Wait a minute, it's gonna come this time. Here it is, here it is. McGraw. Come on, McGraw. I'm shocked McGraw can't do anything. Slaughter really has that hold sunk in there well. No, wait a minute. McGraw coming out of it. McGraw's gonna come out of it. He's on his feet. pound for pound, he can go with anybody. Ah, it looks like McGraw down on his knees, though. I thought McGraw was going to take him. It doesn't look too good at all for McGraw.
He's not out yet.
Look at Slaughter. Slaughter looked at the referee as if to say he gave up already. He gave up. Boy, this capacity crowd really up on their feet. McGraw backs him to the buckle. Rick McGraw, he's going to get his drag him across the ring. Rick McGraw's going to get out of it. Rick McGraw spinning around. So this corner hanging on. Backs it to the buckle. McGraw. Slaughter on his knees, back to his feet. McGraw fighting for every ounce he's worth. McGraw. Yanking, twisting, doing everything conceivable. But Slaughter won't let go. Slaughter hanging on. Slaughter continuing to apply the pressure.
Yes, you can't actually see it on television, but that Slaughter is really sweating.
The referee should stop it, Pat. He should stop it right now. McGraw's going to be hurt seriously.
I'm afraid so.
All right, that's it. A gallant effort as the Grand Wizard raised his hands, and now Sergeant Slaughter likewise raising his hands in a token of victory. But a gallant, a remarkable effort by quick draw Rick McGraw, who has absolutely nothing to be ashamed of.
Unreal, Vince. I really thought he was going to do it. He came awfully close, I must say.
That totally uncalled for. Referee warning Sergeant Slaughter. Pick up a word with Sergeant Slaughter if we can.
My father Tanner said you want to do it now, you yellow belly. Are you chicken or what?
We'll be back in a moment.
Our ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit, introducing in the corner to my right from Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing in at 264 pounds, here is Jack Carson. And his opponent, being led down the aisle by his manager, the fashion plate of wrestling, Fred Blassie. And it is from Borger, Texas, weighing 300 pounds, here is Stan the Lariat Hansen.
The big boy from Texas back here with us, Stan Hansen, and back on Championship Wrestling, Mr. Freddie Blassie, after a rather extensive tour of, well, half of the world anyhow. Blassie back with Hansen, and Hansen taking on Jack Carson, good-sized fellow. The bell's rung. Here we'll go. Hansen yanks him. Hansen all over Jack Carson. Snaps him out again.
Come
That's a tough hombre.
I'll tell you, Vince, 90% of the time when you see Stan Hansen in the ring, you're not going to see a wrestling match. You're going to see mostly a brawl or a fight. Stan Hansen is not the wrestler's type. He just likes to go out there and brawl. He admits it. Hey, I don't know too many wrestling holds, but I'm a winner. And Vince, that's true.
Well, he's certainly been one of the more winning wrestlers in pro wrestling. Certainly as of late, Stan Hansen has really been wreaking havoc all over the World Wrestling Federation.
Vince, a couple of weeks ago, I was in Florida and I went into a record shop and I was looking at some records and I happened to see a record of Fred Blass. I couldn't believe it. Couldn't believe it.
No telling where Blassie's going to show up and in what capacity. Blassie hasn't been with us for quite some time. This is Blassie's first appearance in quite a while, isn't it, Pat?
It has. I would say about a month and a half, and I think he's been over to the Orient again, Vince.
Hansen. All the action is Hansen's, very little on the part of his opposition, Jack Carson. Carson, rhyming his elbow, has some effect on the big bad boy from Texas. However, Hansen quickly turning things around.
Oh, there's no question, Vince. Stan Hansen is a very, very rugged wrestler.
Carson to the rope, heads off. Hansen, ooh, nails him with an elbow. Measuring, driving the knee to the chest area again.
Look at that, the weight, all his weight is on that knee, puts the weight on his knee right across the neck of Jackson. Carson, I should say. I'm telling you, Vince, this guy can just.
Incidentally, really, we've just been given a progress report, actually a doctor's official report. Dr. George Zahorian, the official doctor who was just attending to quick draw Rick McGraw. McGraw is all right, but he fought, did he not, Pat? McGraw, I thought he had the 5,000.
Oh, Vince, I really thought he had it. I thought if someone could do it, that Rick McGraw would do it.
Hansen reversing things quite quickly. Happy to know that McGraw is going to be all right. He just had the feeling he's so heavily muscled in the upper body that actually all over that he had a really good shot at coming out of that. Where do you think he went wrong, Pat? Oh, look at that. We'll get back to Pat Patterson in a moment, but that looks like it was almost curtains for Jack Carson. So, Hansen gets the Duke, and we'll have a word with Pat Patterson in a moment. Let's get the official time.
It is the time, 5 minutes and 1 second, and the winner, Stan Malariat Hansen.
Hansen victorious. Let's take a look at slow motion action now. Hansen really letting him have it. Jack Carson in one end of the ring, one corner. Whipped to the far side. Really thrown in there. From there, Hansen just toying around with his man. Watch him as Hansen whips him. And look at this. Oh, my goodness. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Pat Patterson here with us, and Pat, we'd like to have your commentary on where you feel McGraw went wrong, if you can figure it out.
But the only thing that I would figure out, Vince, is I've been studying the hole myself, and like any other wrestlers, is, of course, Rick's got a strong neck. But when you start fighting that hole, and by kicking your legs and your feet back and forth, you're putting a lot of pressure on your neck, and that's where the downfall is. Because earlier, I thought Rick was doing very good. He was using his strength, trying to push Slaughter's arm up, actually get out of it. But when he started going back and forth around the ring,
he was actually tightening the Slaughter's grip.
Exactly. That's what I feel the mistake is. I don't think you should be really kicking back and forth. I think you should just stay there. And I don't know. I have a couple of things. That, many other wrestlers have different ideas, you know. So that's, to me, that was his mistake.
All right. Thank you very much. Pat Patterson's commentary on the Cobra Clutch. We'll be back.
Our ladies and gentlemen, the next contest set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing 235 pounds, making his first appearance in this arena, here is Jerry Johnson. And his opponent, just making his way down the aisle, from Puerto Rico, weighing 240 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales, the Intercontinental title holder in the non-title match. Mr. Morales getting set to take on John Johnson. The bell is rung. Here we go. Well, again, Mr. Johnson, quickly going to the ropes.
Pedro is demonstrating some beautiful wrestling maneuver. That will be until Jerry Johnson decides to break the rules, and that'll be a mistake.
Couple of snap mares. Morales with a semblance of a front face lock, backs him to the rope. And Pedro with a nice little pat on the pectorals. Morales, a real powerhouse, stands about 6 feet. What do you say his weight is? What was the introduction? Around 240, is it?
240. Vince, he is strong. I know. I've worked out with Pedro many times.
Well, those were hardly punches thrown by Johnson. Morales hauls him over the hip. Stays on top of him. Ooh, works to the midsection. Johnson, oh my, hauled from one side of the ring to the other, and Johnson starts begging off a bit. Perhaps you can see the redness up around the throat in the pectoral area where Pedro Morales has been laying him in. Red all around the neck. Pedro can get you. Nice takedown again.
Vince, I'll tell you, Pedro, ever since he became the Intercontinental Champion, he's had all sorts of challengers, and Pedro likes competition. He likes the big ones. He likes the tough ones. He likes to try them on. He always told me, Pat, if they can beat me, fine, but he says, I like competition.
Look at Pedro, a handful of, oh my! Scoop. Morales has him up. What a slam. Pedro now with Johnson in the air. Down. Ooh, forget about it. Jerry Johnson. No competition. Pedro immediately with a big smile on his face. It's like a night off for Pedro Morales. No competition.
Here is the time. 3 minutes and 8 seconds, and the winner, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales gets the Duke. Now, ladies and gentlemen, next week, the Moondogs, Rex and King, will be challenged by the combination of Dominic DiNucci and Quick Draw Rick McGraw, who should by next week certainly be 100%. The doctor's report, as we said earlier, he's all right. McGraw will be joining Dominic DiNucci against the Moondogs next week. Plus, we've just been told as well, Sergeant Slaughter continues the $5,000 Cobra Clutch Challenge.